Hello and welcome to Marmor Webinar Service Series. This is Irfan here. I work as an analyst with Marmor. Marmor is a majority-owned subsidiary of Kuwait Financial Center, Marcus, established in 2010. Marmor has developed full-fledged research capabilities covering multiple areas such as infrastructure research, economic research, capital market studies, policy analysis, etc. focused on MENA region. Marmor is focused on serving the interdisciplinary knowledge needs of its clients and stakeholders. Questions, if any, could be asked in any time during the course of the webinar, and it shall be addressed at the end of the presentation. And recording will be sent in a day or two, and the same shall be uploaded on our website, Marmor website, and on YouTube channel. And in case of any questions, you can also email them to my email ID, which is irfann@marcus.com. Now we'll be starting our webinar, and first of all, apologies for the delay. We had some technical issue because of which we had to delay the webinar. So in today's series, we'll be discussing about the top wealth creators and stocks which created wealth and destroyed wealth in GCC during the 2006 and 2015 period. Now, before we discuss about the stocks, a brief discussion about the methodology that we have used to identify the stocks and group the stocks together. The first one is our classification of any stocks with the market cap in excess of 3 billion. We have classified them as large cap, and anything or stocks with market cap between 3 billion and 1 billion, we have classified them as mid cap stocks, and anything lesser than 1 billion, we have identified them as small cap stocks. And we have used two different methodologies to identify and group the stocks together. First one is we have identified wealth creators and destructors in terms of absolute value. That is in terms of value gained through capital gains and dividend gain or losses. And the second one, second method is through absolute total return, which is there is stocks we have identified, identified stocks that have created or destructed wealth, both in terms of market cap and dividend, but in terms of total return. We start with identifying the top 10 wealth creators in the large cap segment. It is by value. These are the 10 stocks that have been identified, and these stocks have created an aggregate wealth of close to about 122 billion, both through capital gains and dividends during the 2006 and 2015 period. Now, most of the stocks have generated both positive market cap and dividend paid for the investors. But however, there are few exceptions like Industries Qatar, which in a stock which has lost its market cap during the period. However, a significant amount of wealth was created through dividends for its investors. Two more exceptions would be Jamal Omar Development Company and Saudi Arabian Mining Company. These two companies have created wealth for its investors only through market cap or capital gains, and they have not paid any dividends during the assessment period. In this slide, we have identified the top performers or the top wealth creators in the large cap segment on year basis. We can see that SABIC is appearing during the 2006 and 15 period. SABIC is appearing almost four times in this list. That is in 2007, 2009, 10, and 2013. Now, these are the years when the petrol prices were pretty high, and because the product prices of petrochemical companies or petrochemical product prices are linked to the oil prices, SABIC was able to generate high returns because of this factor. And so SABIC has consistently, it has appeared on as the top wealth creator among large cap for four different years. In this, we have identified the top wealth creators, that is in terms of absolute growth or the total return generated by the stocks. And the Saudi-based Fayaz Abdul Aziz Al Hokair company leads the list. It has generated close to about 18% CAGR return for its investors. And the wealth invested in Fayaz Al Hokair stock has multiplied close to about 5.2 times during the 2016 and 2015 period. Now we can see that most of the companies in this wealth creators in the large cap are from the Qatar. We have close to about five companies from Qatar, and rest are from Saudi Arabia, UAE, and Kuwait. However, we do not have any companies in this segment from Oman or from Bahrain. So this is the breakdown of the stocks, sector-wise and country-wise breakdown. And most of the large-cap stocks that have created wealth are from the financial services sector. And banks from Qatar, UAE, and Kuwait have contributed almost 67% of the wealth created. And in terms of country-wise breakdown of the top wealth creators by growth, majority of the companies are from Qatar, as we discussed, both in terms of number and in terms of the total wealth created are from Qatar, and they have contributed close to 58% of the total wealth created by the top 10 stocks, large cap stocks. This is the risk return profile of the large cap wealth creators, again by top 10 wealth creators in terms of total return generated. Fayaz Abdulaziz generated a CAGR return of 18% during the period, is also the most volatile stock. Now we come to the section where I have identified the top 10 wealth destructors in the large cap segment, and these destructors are in terms of the value that they have destroyed. SABIC makes it to this list as well. We have observed that during the high performance years, it created wealth in excess of $100 billion for its investors. However, during its downturn, it has destroyed close to about 1 trillion in terms of market cap, but to some extent this was compensated by close to about 32 billion, which was paid in dividend by SABIC to its investors. So SABIC leads the group in terms of the top wealth destructors in terms of value. And most of the companies in this segment are from Saudi Arabia, and there is just one company which is from UAE, and MR Properties, most of the market cap that was destroyed was could be attributed to the Dubai real estate bubble burst that Dubai went through, and as a consequence, MR makes it to this list of top wealth destructors in terms of value. Now we'll be talking about the top wealth destructors in terms of absolute return or total return. Bank Al Bilad leads the group in terms of the most return, negative return that was generated for its investors. In terms of market cap, it close to about 10 billion of market cap was destroyed for investors by Bank Al Bilad investors. For most of the banks, the wealth destroyed was primarily during the financial crisis of 2008. That is when most of the banks or the companies from the financial sector have destroyed wealth for the investors. Now the positive market cap for Aldar, we have two companies from UAE, which is making to this list, and the positive market cap, despite generating overall a negative return for the investors by Aldar Properties, is due to recapitalization. In 2011, Aldar Properties was recapitalized, and that is why we have a positive market cap gain for Aldar, despite it generating negative return for its investors. This is the sector-wise and country-wise breakdown for the large-cap wealth destructors. As we witnessed in the top wealth creators for the large-cap, financial services sector leads the top wealth destructors section as well. This could be attributed to to some extent evident that there are banks, financial institutions which have actually managed to come out of or generate despite the financial crisis or bad performance during financial crisis, they have managed to perform better. However, some banks are still struggling to recover the loss that they incurred during the negative impact during that was affected the companies that affected the companies during the financial crisis. The country-wise breakdown of the top wealth destructors, Saudi Arabia dominates the space, so there is close to about 89% of the market cap destroyed by the companies from the Saudi Arabia. This is the risk and return profile of the top wealth destructors in terms of total return. And most of the companies, another aspect that negatively impacted or negatively impacted the performance of the Saudi-based companies is the 2006 stock market crash. In our assessment, we have observed that a lot of companies have had significant losses during 2006 market crash, because of which significant levels of wealth was destroyed for the investors. And for banks, apart from 2008 stock market crash of KSA, the banking crisis of 2008 also had an impact. This is the mid-cap segment for the top wealth creators in terms of the value. And unlike the trend noticed in large cap, where Saudi and UAE companies dominate the space, we have a large presence from companies based in Kuwait in this segment. The total wealth created by these companies, these top 10 mid-cap companies, accounts to almost $22 billion and for the wealth creators, and both in terms of capital gain and dividends. This is these are the 10 companies that we have identified. This is in terms of the previous slide was discussion in terms of absolute values. This is in terms of the total return generated. In this, Kuwait Projects, which is a holding company with interest in several companies, has generated the highest return of 24% CAGR during the 2006 and 2015 period. So wealth invested in Kuwait Projects has multiplied close to about 8 times during this assessment period. Though majority of wealth created for the investors in this by this company comes through dividend. It paid close to about $1.2 billion in dividends, and relatively a smaller amount was generated as wealth for investors through capital gains. Again, the sector and country-wise composition of the mid-cap wealth creators. The financial companies from the financial sector continue to dominate the space, as observed in large cap wealth creators and disruptors. Almost 81% of the 81% of the wealth created by the mid cap also is from the financial services sector. Country-wise breakdown, both in terms of number, as we discussed earlier, number, and now in terms of value, also Kuwait companies from Kuwait lead the space. This is the risk return profile of the top wealth creators for the mid-cap segment in terms of total return. Now the top wealth destructors for top wealth destructors in terms of value for the mid-cap section. Most of the companies in this are from Saudi Arabia. The reason remains the same. Most of the companies lost have not been able to recover from the crisis, a stock market crash of 2006. Some companies like banks were also impacted by the 2008 financial crisis. However, in terms of the most wealth destroyed, UAE-based Dubai Financial Market has destroyed the most wealth among the top 10 wealth destructors in terms of value. And most of this wealth destruction came during the 2008 financial crisis. Here we have the wealth destructors in terms of the total return generated, and Saudi Arabia-based Sahara Petrochemical Company has generated the most negative return of 16% amongst the lot. Sahara Petrochemical again is a petrochemical company, and the reasons for its underperformance or most of its underperformance or wealth destruction has come during the low oil price period, just like SABIC. And the other companies that are there are Bahrain and Arab Banking from Bahrain and Kuwait. The increase in market cap for Arab Banking, despite negative performance, can be attributed to recapitalization, as this bank has been recapitalized on several occasions throughout the 2006 and 15 period. This is the risk and return, sorry, this is the sector and country-wise breakdown of the top 10 wealth disruptors by growth for the mid-cap segment. Again, financial services sector dominates the space, almost 44% of the companies that destroyed wealth belong to the financial services sector. And Saudi Arabia again leads the space, as most of the companies are from Saudi Arabia that have destroyed wealth. It's close to about 29 billion. This is the risk and return profile of the top 10 wealth disruptors. Now coming to the small cap wealth creators in terms of value, we have Medicare Group from Qatar leading the group, and we just have one company from Saudi Arabia that making it to the list. Now there's a trend which is contrary to what we have observed earlier, where majority of the wealth creators have been had been from Saudi Arabia and UAE. However, in the large cap and the mid cap segment, however, in the small cap segment, it appears that the companies from KSA are not there, and it's dominated by other countries. In terms of value created, wealth creators in terms of total return, Oman-based Sweets of Oman, which is into manufacturing of sweets and confectionery, sugar confectionery, is the top performer, which has generated close to about 42% CAGR return for its investors. Its market cap has, in fact, doubled over the assessment period. At the end of 2006, it was the market cap of Sweets Oman was close to about 1 million. However, by 2015, it had reached to 24 billion. And the only company from Qatar that has made it to this wealth creators list is Zaad Holding Company, and it has created the highest wealth worth, 447 in terms of capital gains and 82 million in terms of dividend for its investors. There's the composition of the sector-wise and country-wise composition of the small cap wealth creators. Unlike mid cap and large cap, we have others industrials sector based related companies that are dominating this space, and there is limited presence of financial services in this space. This could also be attributed to the size of the financial services companies, as they are mostly in most cases the size of these companies is large. There is only one company from the utilities which has made it to this list, and that is Oman-based United Power Company, and it has generated and most of its return has wealth created for its investors has been in the form of dividend paid, and it also has the highest dividend yield of close to about 31%. This is the risk and return profile of the small cap wealth creators in terms of total return. And Sweets Oman, which generated the highest return, is also the most volatile stock. It has volatility of close to about 85% amongst the top 10 wealth creators. We have identified the top 10 wealth destructors in terms of value, and Dana Gas, which is a UAE-based company, leads the lot. And it has destroyed close to about 6 billion in wealth in capital gains. In terms of market cap, it has lost. And Dana Gas, along with DR Development and Gulf Investment, are the three companies which have paid absolutely no dividend to its investors during the assessment period. Now in this slide again we have identified the wealth destructors. However, in terms of total return, and most of the companies are from Kuwait, we have two companies from UAE and Bahrain. The most wealth destroyed was by Aldira Holding Company. It generated a negative return of 37% of CAGR for its investors during the assessment period. This is the sector and country-wise composition of the companies of the top wealth destructors for well disruptors for small cap segment. And Kuwait, as we can see, most of the companies are from Bahrain. And however, Kuwait-based International Financial Advisors has wiped highest wealth worth 2.7 amongst the small cap companies. And small cap companies from financial sector account for 87% of the wealth almost 87% of the wealth destroyed for the investors. One interesting trend that can be observed is the wealth created by the small cap companies, large top 10 small cap companies, is close to about 6 billion. That is the wealth created by total return. However, the wealth destroyed by the top 10 small cap companies in terms of total return is close to about 10 billion. This clearly shows the trend of high risk involved with investment in the small cap segment. So this is the risk and return profile of the small cap wealth destructors. And Kuwait Finance and Investment Company is the most volatile stock with a standard deviation of close to about 87%. And Al Dira, as we discussed earlier, has generated the most negative return of 37% amongst the small cap companies. So with this, we have reached the end of our presentation. You may pose any questions that you have. Okay, we have a question from one of our participants. The question is, which stocks do you think would create wealth in 2016? Okay, considering the ongoing scenario in GCC region, which is of low oil price and austerity measures or government spending, government's cutting down on its spending, I think the safest bet would be target sectors from the target stocks from the sectors such as consumer staples and consumer discretionary. At present, they would be the safest bet. And also banks which have significant banking from the government could also be considered, because in most cases they have backing from the government and access to resources because of the government support. So this stock could also be considered or they could also perform well in the present year. Okay, we have another question as to what could you shed some light on what factors drove the wealth creation in terms of, because of the wealth created by companies have been from mostly dominated from the financial services sector, as we observed, and these companies in most cases have strong backing of the government, and like I mentioned, the access to resources because of government banking has in most cases has helped these companies to perform better. Okay, with this, we have come to the end of our presentation. Thank you for your time. And in case of any questions, please email them to us and we'll get back to you. Thank you for your time.